So as you heard just now, since the 50s, various rural development initiatives and projects have been undertaken in Pakistan. While many of them did make a contribution, they generally failed to achieve a transformative impact, because they were not thoroughly backed by the key principles of community development, which are pioneers like Dr. Amit Khan identified and tested first in the Kumila project and later on in the Unagi project. It was the Aga Khan Rural Support Program under the leadership of Shaib Sultan which first adopted these principles for community development and scaled them up later on from Gilgit, Baltistan, Chitral in 82-84 and later on to the rest. And as you also heard, another landmark in this process after AKRSP was the 91 SAARC leaders meeting in 6th summit in Colombo, which established the Independent South Asia Commission on Poverty Alleviation. And this commission, while reporting to the 7th summit in Dhaka, provided a conceptual framework for poverty alleviation through social mobilization and empowerment. And therefore, the SAARC heads of state approved the report and encouraged member states to adopt. So this was a very important landmark because it spread the message of rural support programs as well as community-driven development to the entire South Asian region, and they followed different models and they were adopted in scale in Afghanistan and then Tajikistan, Myanmar, and I think Aga Khan Foundation in East Africa. Within Pakistan, as you heard, the AKRSP model was extended to the whole of Pakistan under an RSP in 1992, followed by many provincial RSPs, and the federal government then also set up a Pakistan Poverty Alleviation Fund in 1997 to provide credit support and also capacity building to these organizations. In 2008, the federal government established the largest social protection program in the history of country. Today, the Benazir Income Support Program provides monthly cash grant to support to 5.5 million poor women. BISP has also been introduced conditional cash support to encourage beneficiaries' families to control their out-of-reach school children. The federal government continues to enhance its support to BRSP. Today, RSPs are, I think, working in 118 out of 131 districts with an outreach of 6 million households. So it's scaling up, and now the challenge in the next 10 years is to take them to at least half the population. And as you will notice in the course of this particular conference, that one of the main reasons for the success of RSPs in Pakistan has been the style of leadership and management. These organizations are led by dedicated and committed people like Fauzia Bibi, who believe in the mission of empowering rural people. They follow a management style that is open, flexible, and foster innovation. Pakistan did not meet many of the Millennium Development Goals, as you probably know, but now, with the kind of infrastructure that we have built and the commitment of the government to convert SDGs into national SDGs, and with financially empowered provincial government, we are much more hopeful that Pakistan will be able to achieve sustainable development goals. And I think in achieving these goals, the community-driven models and people's own organization will become key stakeholders to meet these goals, especially poverty reduction, education, and health. And these are the targets. And so keep that in mind, that at this particular time, as we prepare ourselves for attaining the sustainable development goals, how these community-driven approach can basically contribute to that. I think over the past decades, another area in which community-driven approach is very critical is disaster management. As some of you know, we have had very serious floods in 2010 and 11, and of course earthquake, as well as, and if Pakistan is to manage these in an organized manner, the communities have to be fully involved. First responders to any disaster are the community members. And so therefore, if you have a community-based approach in your area and a disaster strikes, your first response is within the community. Similarly, for climate change adaptation, which Paris is discussing, this is another challenge for the community areas. Communities have to play a leading role at the local level. So you can see that apart from the initial mobilization to education, health, and other things, now much bigger global and regional challenges are now faced. So that's why this conference and learning from each other's experience is critical. And in this context, As you heard, we are very pleased to acknowledge the support of all the donors, European Union, for the RSP in various areas in Balochistan, Khyber, and Sindh. And EU is also working with the provincial government to further expand. Similarly, other donors which are working at the moment through the RSPs are the World Bank, Pakistan Power Generation Fund, Asian Development Bank, UN agencies, IFAD, USAID, DFID, and of course, Australian Aid. Let me conclude by saying that from my long experience in development policy, I am convinced that if the basic needs of the people are to be met, if the inherent potential of the poor people is to be harnessed, then they have to be socially organized into a network of their own organization. They have to mobilize capital and access financial services, enhance their skills in line with the demands of the market, and foster linkages and cooperation with other service providers, including the local government, line departments, NGOs, and market sector. Major development partners have to develop synergies to make the difference, this difference in the lives of the people. The challenge for all of us is to ensure that these organizations, the people, are sustainable and financially viable, and that they are enabled to fully contribute to meet the basic needs of the people through partnership with all the stakeholders. Through people's own organization, we can achieve transformation change that is equitable, productive, sustainable, environmentally friendly, and gender-sensitive, and that will require both entrepreneurship and technology, as Mr. Mahajan emphasized. Finally, I want to take this opportunity to welcome distinguished guests from Afghanistan, India, and Tajikistan. Such events and conferences are important for people-to-people contacts within the region. I wish you all a very successful conference, and I'm confident that not only you will learn from each other's experience, but enriched by this experience, will be able to further intensify your own efforts in your own communities, and the effort, the impact of these efforts will spread far and wide. And in the next 10 to 15 years, South Asia, which is houses more than half the poor people in the world, I think will be able to say that we were able to overcome poverty in a large, to a substantial extent, and one of the key elements was the community development approach. Thank you very much.